Imparting vocational training and education are crucial to sustain and develop economic and social fabric of the society. Recent educational trends are wedded with lucrative and professional training instead of mere theoretical knowledge. For a developing country like Pakistan, which is striving hard on the road of economic prosperity, it is highly demanded to provide skills to the disadvantaged youth, male, female, and disabled, to prove themselves as valuable assets for the country's economy. It is a dangerous trend, both socially and morally, to marginalize and isolate a considerable group of people to inactivity and unprofitable existence. It is a potential threat for socio-economic infrastructure of the family as well as the society. In 2003, the International Labour Organization launched a project of training for rural economic empowerment funded by US Department of Labor. The project envisions vocational capacity building and skills training of the underprivileged and poverty-stricken population of NWFP and Punjab provinces. At its best, the project aims at expanding economic opportunities and social integration of trainees through imparting technical and entrepreneurial skills, creating employment opportunities, and improving interpersonal competence. The direct beneficiaries of the project are poor rural women, disenfranchised youth, people with disabilities. Currently, the project is working in rural areas of District Mardan, including some areas of District Malakand and District Attock, to build and strengthen the capacity of identified groups for self-reliance. The project implementing partners are Federal Ministry of Labor, Manpower and Overseas Pakistanis, Islamabad. Provincial Labor Department of NWFP and Punjab. National Rural Support Program. Technical Education and Vocational Training Authority. Directorate of Technical Education. Project pursues a systems approach, which is holistic and need-based development approach. To ensure the program's validity, a logical framework analysis was carried out to finalize the objectives, outputs, and suggested activities. A stakeholders workshop was organized in which representatives from district government, NGOs, provincial departments of labor, training institutes, and line agencies participated with keen interest. Initially, a baseline survey was conducted in 30 villages from both districts to identify the target group, the needs and opportunities for both males and females. The dynamic project components and program are designed to impart the required employable skills. Three project objectives, methodology and benefit is introduced to beneficiaries through village-level meetings, village camps, workshops, and distribution of promotional material. Special career counseling sessions are held with the target group and their parents or guardians. Skills training for employment and income generation. Trainees are equipped with market-oriented skills and training needed for income generation or wage employment. Small enterprise and credit. Small enterprises are being established through support from the government and NGOs are linked with existing microfinance schemes. Employment promotion. Trainees are guided by expert career counseling in formulating career plans and individual job search strategies. Links with private and public sector prospective employers help to tailor and plans and skills as per requirement. Literacy and numeracy program. Trainees with low literacy and numeracy in functional skills are taught keeping in view ILO's experience in non-formal education and literacy programs. Eventually, these functional literacy centers will be converted into multi-purpose economic activity centers. An important aspect of the project is the provision of post-training support services to all trained beneficiaries. It encompasses placement for apprenticeship, catch market share, promotion of goods and services. Previously, I had very little and non-professional knowledge of electricianing. After getting the training from ILO, I felt a substantial increase in my knowledge and experience. I learned all the technical details by studying theoretical information first and then practically implementing it. I learned all the uses of different types of wiring and switches. I received technical training of beautician from the ILO. It has given me a reputation of a professionally trained beautician among people. It has benefited me in the sense that if one lady visits my parlor, 3-4 other ladies also come seeing my expertise. When I go out, ladies talk about my expertise and proficiency in my profession. I received technical training of auto mechanic from the ILO. I have learned number of skills and hope to learn even more in future. Previously, my income was not good as I used to earn rupees 10 to 20 daily. But after receiving technical training, my income has increased and now I earn rupees 60 to 70 daily. The team of TREE has put our diligent efforts to make learning experience of beneficiaries not only lucrative and beneficial, but also challenging, enjoyable and exciting. The imminent challenges and problems make it a difficult task, but it's potentials and possibilities make all these hardships endurable. TREE is a profound, dedicated, but comprehensive effort to utilize creative talent of underprivileged people to improve their standards of life, alleviate poverty, and be valuable citizens of their country.
Skill training chance for you. Try to find the employment opportunity for you, to try to increase your income for you. So this is our job here. If you feel satisfactory, we feel also happy. If you feel unhappy, if you feel some improvement, please tell us. And we try to improve our work. We try to extend this project for the more years. And also we try to maybe mobilize more resources to this project.
The present project to benefit for the people, target people, and also increase target people in this district as well as the future. I hope that in the next phase we extending the project to some other areas of the province. As I think initially we had already planned that we also be including another district in the next phase. So the efforts and the results of this project in this area will give us the insight and the required expertise to make further improvements and to, with the implementation of this project in other districts, we will be able to achieve even better results.